My name is Leandro Negre. I was born in a family, a hockey family. My father played hockey. For that, when I was really young, I think about 5-6 years, I started my hockey club to play hockey. In Spain, you don't have hockey in the schools. School sport is very poor. It's not organized. Normally are the clubs. So I think all the guys, all the boys at this time, we grow up with a group of friends, playing hockey always in the same team. And I think my skill as a goalkeeper, always I've been a goalkeeper, became quite good. For that, I was selected for the national team of Spain. I started when I was 5 years, I think in 1950, 1951. Yeah, more or less that. I was born in 46, for that. I don't remember it exactly, but it was, I think, 50, 51 or, yeah, or 50. But immediately I played for the junior team. That means still in Spain it was still 18 years old, when I was at this moment perhaps only 12 or 13. And I was really lucky because our goalkeeper of the first team, they moved to another club, but really I needed a goalkeeper. At this moment I was only 15, 16. I start to play with the first team when I was really very young, for these specific circumstances. But I learned a lot, because to be too young and to play with the top players at this moment. My first appearance as an official match, it was against Austria in Vienna, and it was in 1963. And also I did the preparation for the Olympic Games in Tokyo in 64. Knowing I was the third goalkeeper, I was too young, but they need some goalkeeper to go ahead with all the preparation, just in case it was some injury in one of the other ones. I didn't go to Tokyo, but next to the Olympic years I was selected again, and I played the Olympics in 68 in Mexico City. I tell you, it was in summer, about 37, 38, yeah. And at this moment there was two pools of 8 teams. That means you play about 9 matches in 12 days. It was difficult, but we've been training for that. Our federation provides a hockey pitch at 2,000 meters on the Pyrenees, just for training. For that we are resisting. And the Olympic, we get the 6th position. We play against Holland for the 5th and 6th position. And that is the longest hockey match of the history. It is in the Guinness Book of Records, because at this time it was not penalty shootout now or penalty stroke competition. For that you have to play extra times till one of the teams scored one goal. And we played 12 extra times, or 7.5 minutes. 80 more plus 70, 150 minutes. It was really the last match of the Olympics, with 37-38. And the funny thing is the tournament director decided to be execo is the last 12 extra times, still it was no goals. And Holland scored the goals in the last second of this 12 extra time. But, you know, you are upset for the first hour. After that, we celebrate, nice drinks, and everything is over. Yeah. I met the guy, he was a fantastic player for Holland, the center forward. He scored the goal. We met often in Holland. You have some drinks together, just to share all these nice memories together. Yeah. Yeah.
So how did you move then from player to administrator?
Well, that is a nice question for me, because many people, now being the president of FIH, is thinking that it was a goal in my life to achieve these things. I promise you, not at all. But not at all. Different circumstances that they put me in this position. The Catalan Hockey Federation is the most important hockey area in Spain. They asked me just to help him. He was a nice senior man with fantastic capacities for hockey. It was a pity he just passed away a few months ago. And well, he believed in me. I became vice president of the Catalan Federation with him. And I think we did a nice job together. You make a nice team. I think about 8 years later, it was the possibility to stand for president of the Spanish Hockey Federation. It was a quite difficult elections because he was another candidate from Madrid. And you know, Spain, the fight between Barcelona and Madrid is something else, something serious. But yeah, I win. I was also in 92 member of the executive organizing board of the Olympics, representing the Spanish Olympic Committee. And yeah, I have a good experience. Also, our national ladies team, they won the gold medal. So that it was a fantastic achievement. And after that, they say, that is the moment I have to leave, to be president. It was after 8 years, I think it was enough. And I start inside of the European Federation as vice president. The president this morning was Alain Danet, a man from Paris, from France. He was a very nice president, being nearly 30 years president of the European Federation. From the beginning, I told with him, I said, listen, I am your vice president, I never will fight against you, never at all. And when you stop at this moment, I will think. And yeah, he took a decision to stop. And also, he promoted me to be the president of the European Federation. I think I have good qualities for relations. Relations with the people. I think I have an easy, nice approach. And along my experience, people believe in me. And that is nice. And I think I am also a person that I keep my, when I promise something, I keep my promise.